There's going to be a civil war in this country, and it's going to come soon. The only thing that can stop it is by waking up vast amounts of sleeping people. Sheeple is what they are. They are following the Judas goat right into the shearing pens, and from there they will go to the slaughter, and they will not know that anything is wrong until they smell the blood of the sheeple in front of them.
And that means you can't rely on the media as it is today either.
Oh, of course not. All the media in this country, radio, television, and print, is all owned by five corporations. All of these corporations that own the media are owned and controlled, and members of the Council on Foreign Relations sit on their board of directors. Remember, if you go down and you trace the ownership of a station or a newspaper, and you get to a corporation, remember that somebody owns that corporation, and it's usually another corporation. But when you trace the interlocking of all these things, when you get to the top, there's five. And all journalists know that there's some things you don't write about and you don't talk about because you'll lose your job. And that's where the control is. And that's why they pay anchormen like Dan Rather $2 million a year, because he doesn't question them. He knows that if he goes against them, he's going to lose $2 million a year. Do you think a man that looks pretty and sits in front of a TV camera for the 6 o'clock news is worth $2 million a year? No way. I don't care how long he works and I don't care what he does. There is no job worth $2 million a year. That's why they pay athletes these fantastic salaries. I was listening to the radio the other day. They just contracted to pay one player on one team $6 million a year. Can you believe this?
And why is that?
It's the Roman circus. What does the emperor do when the people become restive, and when the people are asking questions, and when the people don't like the policies of the emperor? He sends them to the circus. He creates a circus. He builds a giant coliseum. And he begins to throw the Christians to the lions. And he has great chariot races and football games and basketball games, all to keep the idiots preoccupied with things that don't mean anything in the scheme of the entire world.
And then the big political and economic question of the 21st century will be, what do we need humans for? Or at least, what do we need so many humans for?
Do you have an answer in the book?
At present, the best guess we have is keep them happy with drugs and computer games.
So that they don't have the time to learn what the truth is. So they don't ever get smart enough to learn how they're being manipulated. So they don't ever question the emperor. That's why they pay a player on a football team or a baseball team $1 million or $2 million or $3 million a year.